I fall into the vision. The burning blood fades. The world reshapes itself into the half of a battle barge. We seek the great enemy, and it is only here that we will find him. Walls of stone and blasphemous iconography rise above me. I see the enemy. I see Horus. I am racked by burning pain. There is why. Horus has slain the angel. Brothers, I cry, avenge our father. As one, we streak towards Horus. The weakened portion of my mind that knows this is delusion cries out to me. I have found the enemy, but I cannot fight him through a lie. The wrench is massive. I am torn between two times, two worlds, two reals, but I see the truth again. I lead the Death Company in a direct flight through the billowing fire of blood at Scarbrand. All our force is concentrated into a spear formation. We unleash a hail of bolter fire before us. Scarbrand flinches. The shells damage his form. The answer comes to me. Why would traitors seek redemption? What makes a demon desperate? Betrayal. Somehow, in some form, Scarbrand and the Blood Disciples are racked with regret for a betrayal. I do not have to know its nature. It is enough to know the weakness is there. And in this moment, the warriors of the Death Company believe themselves to be avenging the greatest betrayal in our history. We strike at the demon's weakness, his consciousness of sin. He retaliates with still greater fury. The axes come together with blood and fire and the searing, jagged black of rage. I see the blow coming. I kill the propulsion of my jump pack and drop down. My brothers see an attack, but they see Horus, and Scarbrand is a colossus. The lie of the vision dooms many. The materium screams as the axes collide. Figures in black armor are torn apart by the fragmenting reel, but there are still more of us, and the charge continues. Scarbrand roars in pain and wrath. He smashes more of the Death Company to the ground at the same time that I am rising again. I shoot up, straight up, between the massive sweeps of the demon's weapons. At the zenith of my climb, I am level with his eyes. I bring the Blood Crozius down with all the strength of purified, holy wrath upon his skull. The sacred relic shatters bone. Scarbrand's roar deafens me. He drops an axe and snatches me out of the air. His grip is crushing. I cannot breathe. I feel my frame splinter, but my arms are free and I strike again. Focused on me, he has left himself open to the rest of the Death Company. The shells from my brothers hit his chest and the throat at the same time. Demonic ichor sprays into the air, combusting when it contacts the flaming blood. Still holding me, Scarbrand looks down. His lethal roar falls upon my brothers. But they have fired one last volley, and I strike one more time. And the sin of the demon overwhelms his material form. With a howl to blot out all light, he loses the coherence of his rage. He explodes, and all realities disappear in the instant of absolute conflagration. Chaplain Lemartes serves within the Blood Angels Death Company during the era Indomitus. Falling to the gene curse of the Black Rage during Hadriarch 11, Lemartes, unlike his fellow kin, survived the assault of the war against the Orc Xenos. With battle concluded, Lemartes collapsed from his wounds incurred, and in his exhausted state, demanded life when confronted by Astorath the Grim during his duty to cull the remaining Death Company Astartes. Never in the history of the Blood Angels had an Astartes retained enough sanity after being subsumed by the rage to the point where they could communicate in a sane manner to their peers. His eyes bloodshot and muscles straining with barely constrained anger, his words nonetheless proved to stay the axe blade of the Redeemer of the Lost. Ordering the Chapter Apothecaries to seal Lemartes within stasis until his return to Baal, his body would be observed and studied by the librarians and sanguinary priests of the chapter to find answers for his resistance to the curse. For solar months, Lemartes lay dormant within stasis, his mental and physical state scrutinized by every expert of the chapter. His surrender to the Black Rage without question, his mind regardless, remained intact through sheer willpower and his stubborn fealty to serve the Emperor. Arguing such a state to be temporary, the sanguinary priest believed his madness would soon return, yet Astorath refused to slay Lemartes. Awakening the chaplain from his long slumber, Astorath offered him a new duty to be made in the name of the Master of Mankind and glory of the Great Angel. Assuming the title of Guardian of the Lost, Lemartes was bequeathed the ancient Blood Crozier's chapter relic, said to have been wielded by the first Blood Angel's chaplain, and began his task to lead the future Death Companies as their leader. Charged to watch his kin fight and die by his side, though none would live past a single battle under his watch, their focused slaughter proved capable of rending the most dangerous of any foes. Placed in stasis following each of his deployments, Lemartes sleeps for as little as weeks or as long as solar months, until once more being unleashed to resume his endless rampages as the zealous master of the Berserk Angels. Suspected to one day eventually lose his battle in retaining his sanity, whilst he continues to slay the enemies of the Blood at the vanguard of his host, Lemartes stands as a symbol of the Blood Angels' enduring resilience and glory. His charges the substance of legend among the ranks of his chapter. The continued deeds of Lemartes made in the name of the Angel inspire his brethren to never willingly surrender to their inner demons, giving stark hope that one day they may prove strong enough to conquer their gene flaw.